Now for class 7, this is a video for you as per your running chapters. Class 7 mathematics, welcome to my class. Chapter 2, introduction to the rational numbers. Okay, what is a rational number? First question, the simple question everyone asked to you, what is a rational number? A number is of the form f a by b, where a and b are integers, b is not equal to 0, then you can call this a rational number. You can easily exemplify also, you can any example you can take. Here some example given, -3 by -7, -13 by 13, -6 by -7, 0 by -7, etc. So different example, you can also give your own example. Next question to you, are natural numbers, whole numbers and integers are rational numbers? Okay, let us see what can be the answer. Natural number, as you know, is natural number, as you know, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, up to the counting number. W is the set of whole number, that is 0, including 0, all counting numbers. And integers, it includes both negative and positive whole numbers with 0. Positive and negative whole numbers with 0. So all will be your natural number, whole number and integers. Now let us take 0. 0 can be written as 0 by 2, 0 by minus 8, 0 by 1. Any number you can take. Hence it changes into a fraction, a rational number. 5. 5 can be written as minus 5 by minus 1, minus 5 by 1, 10 by 2, minus 15 by minus 3. Therefore it can be also a rational number. If you take a negative number which is there in the integers, it can be 3 by minus 1 or minus 3 by 1, minus 9 by 3 or 15 by minus 5. All such numbers, you can say also the rational number. Therefore, all the numbers what is there in natural number, whole number and integers also are rational numbers. Here we have query, 0 by 0. Can we call this a rational number? Since 0 by 0 cannot be a rational number because here denominator of this is 0. So it cannot be a rational number. So if denominator is 0, it cannot be rational number, whatever the number you can take. However, simply 0 if you take it is a rational number. Here another question query for you. Okay. What is the terminating, what are terminating and non-terminating decimals? How they are helpful to know about the given number or given rational number, is a given number is a rational or irrational? Okay, let us see. Here some example for understanding terminating and recurring decimals. First, terminating decimals. You might have seen some fractions when you divide the numerator by denominator, their decimal places come to an end at a certain decimal place. For example, if you take 1 by 4, divide 1 by 4, so you will find out 0.25. 2, if you divide by 5, you can get 0.4. 3, if you divide by 8, you will get 0.375. So there might be some other number which can also come to the end at a certain decimal places. Such decimal numbers you can call terminating decimals. Similarly, some other form also possible. 1 by 3, if you divide 1 by 3, you will find out it will be 0.333, it have to go to infinite, or you can write also a bar, 0.3 bar. If you take 2 by 3, if you divide 2 by 3, you will find out 0.666 is up to infinite. Or you can use also the short form 0.6 bar. Suppose you will take 3 divided by 3 by 7. Now divide 3 by 7, will find out. It will form a sequence of decimals like 0.42754285714285714 and so on. So therefore, this will be a repeating sequence of 428571. So it can be written also 0.428571 bar or 0. Put a dot on the first number and one at the last number, put a dot and explain. That is your recurring decimals. Keep in mind, terminating decimals and recurring. So these are recurring decimals, you can say non-terminating but repeating. They are called recurring decimals. Keep in mind, terminating and recurring decimals are your rational numbers. Next, about irrational numbers. Irrational numbers, numbers which forms a non-terminating decimal when you divide the numeral, when you can obtain a non-terminating decimals. Sometimes some numbers are there. If you take, you divide them or you find out the square root, etc., square root, cube, they will be forming unending, terminating, non-terminating decimals. Such numbers you can call your irrational numbers. One of the example of pi. Pi you are using for finding area of circle or perimeter of circle, etc., and some other also you are using for different kinds of geometrical models. So here pi, you can say the pi value, it is also irrational number. However, we are taking a proposed or approximate value for pi, that is 22/7 or 3.14 or 3.141. However, 22/7, when we are taking, this becomes a recurring decimal, hence it is a rational number. But pi is a rational number. Some more rational numbers are root 2, root 3 plus 1, 2 minus root 3, some other numbers also, you can root 3 by 2, 2 by root 3, any number you can take like that with the irrational numbers. Okay, now finally some questions for you, a simple question for you to answer. It is right, true or false, but it is critical to think and answer. Every integer is a rational number. Second question, O is smallest rational number, 0 is smallest rational number. Third, there is no longest rational number, largest rational number. There is no largest rational number. Fourth, 0 by 0 is a rational number. And finally, 0 by 5 is a rational number. So these questions require your critical thinking and answering. Think and answer the questions. If you like the video, you can share and subscribe and give necessary comment for further improvement.